Hi there. My name is Dimitris Haralabidis. I'm a math teacher. And in this video, we are going to work together an example on how to conduct a t-test. So here's the example. Jason believes that there is a difference in the life expectancy between people living near the sea and people living close to a mountain. For this reason, he gathered two samples of people from two different places and marked their current ages. His results can be seen in the following table. And the first note we have to do here is that, as we all remember, in a t-test, the two samples don't have to be of the same size. We can see that Jason was able to gather 12 ages from the sample of people living near the sea, but on the other hand, he just gathered 10 people who live close to a mountain. But still, again, for a t-test, that's perfectly fine. Let's move on. Jason decided to conduct a t-test with a 5% level of significance. State an assumption that he's making in order to use a t-test. This will be a very common question in exercises with t-tests. And all we have to do is that he is assuming that the two samples follow a normal distribution. The two samples follow a normal distribution. That's all we have to write, distribution. Let's move on, question B. State the null hypothesis for this test. The null hypothesis in a t-test is always the one that states that the means of these two samples are equal. So if mean one is the mean of the first sample of the people living close to the sea, and mean two is the mean of the second sample of those who live close to a mountain, then we assume that the means of these two samples, the means of the two samples are equal. And that is always our null hypothesis. Moving on, in C, state the alternative hypothesis for this test. Regarding the alternative hypothesis in a t-test, there are three options. The first one is that the two means are different. The second one, that mi one is bigger than mi two. And the third one, that mi one is smaller than mi two. It all depends. It's up to us to understand through the given information which one to choose. And let's read again the given information. Jason believes that there is a difference. He simply believes that there is a difference. He doesn't state that he believes that those who live close to the sea tend to live more than those who live close to the mountain or the opposite. So since he just believes that there is just a difference, our alternative hypothesis will be simply the one stating that they are different. Therefore, written in words, we could write that the means of the two samples are different. Okay. Is it a two-tailed or a one-tailed test? Justify. This question has to do about, it is strongly related to the alternative hypothesis H1. In H1, we wrote that the two means are different, but this leaves us with two options. The mean of the first sample can either be greater, or the mean of the second sample can be greater. This means that we have two choices, and therefore it will be a two-tailed test. So we would write as a justification, from H1, we get two choices, which means that it will be a two-tailed test. E, find the p-value for this test. Luckily, this one will be done from our calculator, from the GDC. You can take a look on a previous video and find out all the commands that we apply specifically in the Casio GDC to find the p-value. And by doing that, we will get that the p-value here is equal to 0.665, rounded in three significant figures. And finally, state the conclusion explaining your reasoning. Let's see the things we know from theory. We know that we should reject the null hypothesis if the p-value is smaller than the significance level. Significance level. On the other hand, we fail to reject. Remember that we do not say we accept H sub zero, we just say we fail to reject H sub zero and reject H1 if the p-value is bigger than the significance level. Here, we just found that p-value is equal to 0.665. The significance level was 5%, which of course equals to 0.05. We are in the second case where the p-value is bigger than 0.05, and therefore we fail to reject H sub zero, but we definitely reject H1, which means that there is not a difference in life expectancy. And that was all. For any questions you might have on this exercise, you can always leave comments below the video, or you can directly contact me on my personal email. As always, thank you for your time.